about this Nature Materials paper published in 2013, Degradation Mediated Cellular Traction Direct Stem Cell Fate in Covalently Cross-Linked Three-Dimensional Hydrogel, published by Jason Birdy Group. So, in summary, they cultured the cell, stem cell, in 3D structure, not 2D. And then they are using covalently cross-linked 3D hydrogel. So covalent cross-linking is just natural when you make some biopolymer. So they should be polymerized by UV treatment or some radical. This is we can call it covalent cross-linking. Covalent means very strong. And then they, how can I say? They permanently maintain their structure. Yeah. The another contrast meaning of covalent bonding is ionic bonding. Ionic. Ionic means plus minus, right? So in case of ionic bonding, they can be slip. Yeah. In case of covalent cross-linking, they should not slip. Slip means like sliding. Covalent cross-linking, they cannot slide, but ionic bonding, they can slide, which means this bond, maybe this is a plus, 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 minus, 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 plus, minus, they can, minus ion can be shift on the plus surface. This is a shifting or sliding. So based on this conception, you can understand this result. So they are using methacrylate hyaluronexide. Hyaluronexide is one of the nature origin matrix, mostly consisting of your cartilage. But this methacrylation is covalent cross-linking methacrylation, very well known. So using this hyaluronexide backbone, they methacrylate it additionally, and then they add cell adhesion peptide, including RGD sequencing. RGD, the cell doesn't have any eyes, don't have any eyes, right? How they attach on the substrate? They're using their hands and foot, which is filopodia or lamellipodia, to sense and touch the RGD. And then when they recognize RGD, they start to activate the integrin to catch the RGD. RGD is one of the amino acid sequencing. So you can imagine cell only attach, not only, but cell most are prone to attach the RGD sequencing protein. Yeah. So that is why they are additionally adding RGD sequencing as a peptide. And then when they turn on the UV or some certain light, this methacrylation can be polymerized. Polymerized means monomer can be sequentially linked together and then turn to be polymer. Monomer is single, polymer is many, right? So previously, what we learned before, in case of stiffness, when we change it, 2D different surface, high stiffness, more prone to increase the osteogenesis of the stem cell. But meanwhile, when you culture the MSC on sub-stiffness, they are more prone to differentiate adipocyte or neuron cell, right? So we can expect, in case of 2D, high stiffness, osteogenesis. And how about in 3D? They culture the five different stiffness from 4 to 100 kilopascal, and then 3D culture the stem cell. And then when they culture, they use half and half mixed media, half adipogenic, half osteogenic. So they can determine their cell fate. If they want to go adipogenic, they can go adipogenic, like red color. Red is lipid droplet. When stem cell want to go osteogenesis, they are stain as violet color, which is ALP, osteogenic. But as you can see, all cell are prone to adipogenic, no osteogenic, right? This is exactly contrary effect to the 2D stiffness. When you culture this in 2D, high stiffness, they can accelerate osteogenesis, right? But this is the opposite. So they're surprised. Wow, how they change it? So this is their quantification. All of them are adipogenic, then osteogenic. And then they only culture the osteomedia, not half and half. Also, in that case, osteogenic differentiation is very less, 20%. This is exactly contrary to the 2D result. In 2D, in case of 20 or 100, all cell can be differentiated into the osteogenic cell, but not in 3D structure. But when they activate the rock, rock can mediate cellular traction force. So just imagine when you increase the rock, cell have some more power. And then in same condition, osteogenic is increased, enhanced. So which means somehow in 3D, the rock signaling is suppressed. So there is no osteogenic, but when we extracellularly reinforce the rock signaling, the cell in 3D can differentiate into osteogenic. So we can say that matrix, maybe how matrix can change the stem cell fate mediated by rock signaling. Even though they are using same platform, but when you externally activate the rock, they are differentiate into the osteo. So rock is a major signaling. So maybe, yes, I'll show you later. And then this figure F, so they can ask, this kind of 3D phenomenon can be observed only in your material. How about when you culture in other material? They can ask. So first, they are using Meha anti-CD44. CD44 is a Moyat, special Moyat in hearing exit, which can be recognized by chondrocyte. So maybe CD44 can have some working. So they're in the presence of the anti-CD44 to block the CD44 in hearing exit, also in the same manner, no osteogenesis. So this is not mediated from special Moyat in hearing exit, CD44, just general. And then they are using alginate metacylation, dexatran metacylate gel. Similarly, cobalt cross-linking through the metacylation, but their backbone is different. Previously, hyaluronic acid, alginate, dextran, and all show similar. So this means they can generalize this 3D covalent cross-linking 3D gel. When they are covalent cross-linking link, the stem cell cannot differentiate to the bone, even though they are in the high stiffness, right? Okay. Then next, okay. Then how they make the 3D gel to the less stiffness, or how the stem cell can change their fate in osteogenesis? So for that, they are making another gel, but same backbone. This metacylation, hyaluronic acid, and then they additionally put this malamide. Okay, so this MEMAHA, malamide incorporated MEHA. So, and then they also adding cell adhesive peptide like previous one, RGD, and an MMP degradable peptide, which means MMP, when the cell can secrete MMP during their cell cycle or metabolism, and then MMP, because of MMP from cell, this peptide can be degraded. So we can say that this is a cell inducible degradation can occur using this MMP peptide. So first, they making the gel. How they make it? This MMP degradable peptide and cell adhesive peptide, and then because of this malamide structure, they are cross-link each other. But they didn't use the metacylation at the first moment, D0, they didn't use it. But when they without UV, the cell try to secrete the MMP, and then over time this matrix can be degraded or some part can be cleaved, right? And then this is one thing, so which means cell can change the matrix stiffness. They didn't mention detail here, but cell can change their stiffness by the degradation of the matrix. This is upper, minus UV. But when they introduce UV, the kinetic chain, which is covalent cross-linking, can occur, right? While the cell also can secrete some MMP, right? But even though the MMP degradable chain can be cleaved, but they are already highly cross-linked through the metacylation by the UV, and then the cell cannot change the matrix. So this is plus UV. So when you culture the cell on plus UV, cell morphology doesn't change. But when you culture minus UV, over time, matrix can be degraded, and the cell can change their ECM formation, and then cell can spread. And then this kind of spreading, non-spreading, somehow can change the stem cell fate. This is their question, their concept. So this is their quantification of their gel. Memaha, and then without UV, only this malamide peak disappear, because when they try to cross-link the gel, they are using some special agent like DTT, something like. This is some DTT has some thiol group, SH. The thiol group can attack the malamide, and then they can covalent cross-linking. And they very, not strongly like metacylation, but somehow they can covalent cross-linking. So, minus UV, when they are cross-link, malamide peak disappear, because they are used for cross-linking. And then, when they add UV again, this metacylation peak disappear. So metacylation is working. And then they check the H release to confirm the degradation. From the, in the presence of MMP, they mimic this, when they culture the cell, MMP can be secreted from cell. But in here, without cell, they just externally add the MMP. So when they minus UV, in the presence of MMP, HA release, which means the matrix can be degraded. But in after UV, D0, HA not release, right? So we can confirm our designed material concept, okay? This is without cell, without cell. So you can imagine with UV, they are all covalent cross-linking strongly. So even though MMP can degrade this MMP degraded peptide, which can link some matrix chain, but no release, no degradation of matrix. But without UV, because this first malamide and TTT mediated cross link is a little bit soft, so the MMP can degrade the matrix and then HA can be released. And then now they culture the cell. Initially, they match the stiffness. Initially, 4 kilopascal. First, without UV. This with UV. And culture 3 days in gross condition. Gross means no differentiation supplement. Only stem cell can grow. But while they are growing, they are spreading and they are elongated. But with UV, because cell cannot change their matrix, they are maintain their spherical structure. And then bead displacement is a high bead displacement means ECM can be deformable by the cell. But low bead displacement means no cell change of the matrix. So bead, we externally incorporate the FITC conjugated bead inside of the gel. So we cannot see the real matrix deformation, but instead indirectly, when bid in metrics, when they are changed, we can expect the ECM can be changed by the cell. That is why instead of the metric deformation, we are using bid displacement. Okay, in that way to check the deformation of the matrix. And then they further check minus plus. This is no change of matrix. They are allowable change it. Some vinculin actin, they are well formed. Whereas vinculin actin is less formed in the presence of UV. And then they 7 days of growth, means like this. And then they culture the 7 day further in half and half mixed media. Okay. So this after 7 days later of the differentiation media in mixed condition, cell morphology maintained. Maintained means this cell almost similar, right? Cell morphology not that much change, but still bit displacement and circularity also along with the previous one. But in minus UV, what happened? Minus UV, this formation, osteogenic differentiation can be enhanced. While with UV, no osteogenic, only adipogenic. Okay? So we can say that, previously, if we culture only metacylation mediated cross-linking structure from the 2 to 100 kPa, no osteogenic, right? But here, if we use cell-mediated degradation gel, like this minus UV condition, cell can change their morphology, and then they can induce osteogenic differentiation. And then, liver can ask, okay, maybe this is from their original cell shape. Cause, okay, I can understand. This high osteogenic can be detected in minus UV, which allow the matrix deformation. But this is really from the matrix deformation or from the initial cell morphology, right? When they cell are originally round shape, and then when you incubate them for 14 days in differentiation media, what will happen? So they want to decouple, shape is important, or matrix deformation is important. Here, they are combined together. Matrix also can be changed by the cell in case minus UV, and then original cell morphology also different between them. So next, they in minus UV condition, they culture the cell for 7 days, and then all cells are spreading. And then they expose 4 minute UV and without UV. Plus UV means further cell cannot change their matrix. But without UV, cell can change. So here, this is one. T7 UV. This is T7 without UV. This is T7 UV. So at 7 days, in here, their cell morphology similarly spreading. But after that point, they treat without UV, UV. UV means further culture condition, cell cannot change the matrix. But without UV, cell can change the matrix. So here, initial cell morphology is matched, but depending on cell change the matrix or not, minus UV, cell matrix deformation condition can enhance bit displacement as well as osteogenesis. But when you added UV to decrease the ECM matrix deformation by the cell, they are more adipogenic. And then this bit displacement also very diminished. Okay? So this panel B is this is some T7 UV at the moment, T7. And then this is after 3 days further incubation. as a representative images. So we can say that initial cell morphology is not important. Whether they are first, not they are not showing the sphere cell morphology, but even though two cells are similarly spread, but while they are cultured in different media, depending on the matrix, allowable deformation or matrix diff, cell can go osteogenesis in matrix deformable condition, but stem cell cannot go osteogenesis, but go adipogenesis in non-deformable condition. Then next, they want to know the further mechanism. So they are using two different gel, 2.5, 1.5. So bit displacement is more higher in 2.5 weight percent. And then when they treat Y is some inhibitor of the RORAC pathway. Previously we mentioned RORAC is enhanced, cell more osteogenic, right? So in here we deactivate the RORAC using this Y27. When Y27 is treated, bit displacement decrease. And then regardless of circularity, so when you show like this, this circularity in the presence of the Y, especially the bit displacement, this is very high. You can see red or some green color here. But in case of Y, when you block the RORAC pathway, most of the bit can shown as blue color, which means cell cannot change the matrix. And then when they culture the D7 UV condition, D7 UV means they are at D7 condition they added UV to stop the deformation, and then also most of the matrix cannot deformed. All color is blue, no change of the bead. And then after 7 days of this gross media condition, they culture the cell under differentiation media, half and half. And then minus UV, matrix deformable condition, more bead displacement, more osteogenesis. In the presence of Y, when they block the RORAC pathway, even they are cultured in the same condition, no bead displacement, no osteogenesis. And then in adversely, adipogenesis is more enhanced. So they want to say matrix, when stem cell can differentiate either bone or adipogenic, this RORAC pathway is very important. RORAC pathway governs this phenomenon. And then cell fills the matrix, and through this RORAC pathway, cell can differentiate into the bone in high RORAC signaling and adipo in low RORAC signaling. End of the paper. So, any question? Aria? Perfect? Haryun?
I'm fine.
Yeah. Exactly same as what you expect. The contents of the paper. I mean, when you read the paper,
yeah,
and then I summarize it. Mm-hmm. So it is similar what you imagine, yeah, and what you read.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm. So, and here only they mention about the stem cell fate, adipo and osteogenic, right? So when you change the cell to the immune cell, like macrophage, what will happen? Maybe macrophage, they will feel lovely in non-deformable matrix,
mm-hmm,
or deformable matrix. Actually, no study has been done.
Mm-hmm.
So in iTrain, we are planning to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if we make this similar gel, now we are making, Professor Henley, when she make it, maybe some people are interested in that. Maybe we are culturing the macrophage, neutrophil, any kind of immune cell, and then how they change their immune response. But our hypothesis is that maybe more deformable condition is happier for immune cell, which means they show less inflammation, cytokine. They are more chained to the anti-inflammation condition easily. There is our hypothesis. So in here, they didn't mention in detail about the sex relaxation, and then they didn't check the stiffness in the degradation phase, right? They only matched the first stiffness, like here, like 4, right? But minus UV condition, maybe over 7 or 40, over further culture condition, because of MMP degradable matrix degradation, this 4 kilopascal, they can be decreasing, right? Around 2 and 1. But in case of with UV, no change, right? They didn't check the stiffness here. So, but we can easily imagine this, maybe stiffness can go down without UV because of MMP mediated degradation. Or in another term, if we apply the stress relaxation, maybe this is more stress relaxing condition than with UV condition. With UV cell, they try to use their power to change the matrix, but because they are highly covalent cross-linking, the cell cannot change the matrix, which is related to the low stress relaxation. Stress cannot be diminished from the matrix, so cell cannot shake the matrix. This is a slow stress relaxation. It will take longer time to change the matrix. But in without UV condition, matrix is deformable, and then cell can have a shorter time, fast time to change the matrix. So we can link this is a more high stress or fast stress relaxation matrix. Maybe next paper is linked to the stress relaxation, right? Yeah, someday you will read the paper, stress relaxation mediated. We already did? Not in, right? Stress relaxation mediated. Maybe later, that is our next paper. So, stress relaxation concept is revealed in 2016 or 17 in another Nature Motor paper. So, later you can link them. So anyhow, here, the importance about not only stiffness, but initial stiffness is also very important. But while they are culturing the cell, the stiffness can be changed. Or stress relaxation, how long cell can take the time to change the matrix is important. So in 3D condition, you have to always consider initial stiffness as well as this stress relaxation. So we can say that all covalent link hydrogel, like BHA, BALG, other this one doesn't have any stress relaxation. Like your elastic eraser. Can you imagine an eraser? When you use your eraser, or some bow, elastic bow, when you push them, they continuously make the tension. But when you push let's say, tofu, when you push tofu, initially they feel some resistance, but over time, this resistance can be diminishing, which is the meaning of the stress relaxation. Okay, later you can understand better.